Hello, my dear students. Myself, Dr. Jaspreet Kaur, Assistant Professor in Psychology from GHT Khalsa College of Education, Guru Sir Sudhar. Today, I will discuss with you one of the most important topic in current educational scenario, that is inclusive education. In my presentation, I will cover the concept of inclusive education, its benefits and scope. I hope you will like this presentation. So, let us start.
Hello dear students. Firstly, we will discuss the meaning of inclusive education. Inclusive education is a process for increasing participation and reducing exclusion in a way that effectively responds to diverse needs of all. This means adapting the education system to meet the needs of individual rather than changing the individual to fit the system. So, dear students, here focus is on to reducing the exclusion rate of children with special needs so that we can effectively respond to their diversity. Moreover, it also means that we have to make a change in the system so that such children can be fitted into the regular education system rather than making a change in the individual itself. Next, inclusion means full inclusion of children with diverse abilities in all aspects of schooling that other children are able to enjoy. Or here we want to clear one thing, that if we are talking about inclusion, it means that we have to fully include these children in all the activities of the school with their diverse abilities. Next, according to UNESCO, inclusive education rests on three things. So, three things are important. First, the physical presence of students within the mainstream schooling system. It means children with special needs or diverse abilities have to be present physically. Next, their full and active participation within the school life. Moreover, not only presence but their participation should also be acknowledged. And third one is their achievement of the highest standard that they are capable of with the development of new skills. So focus should be on achievement of highest standard by helping these individuals to develop new skills. Now, what is the promise of inclusive education? It is to bring all students together in one classroom and community and seeks to maximize their potential. So, we have to bring all students under one roof and to maximize whatever potential they inherit. It is an effort to make sure that diverse learners, those with disability, different language and culture, different homes and family lives, different interests and ways of learning are exposed to teaching strategies that reach them as inclusive learner. So our focus should be on using such teaching strategies that will be used for each learner belonging to a different type of diverse ability. Inclusive school asks teachers to provide appropriate individualized support and services to all students without the stigmatization that comes with separation. Moreover, inclusive schools have to provide individual support to each learner with diverse or different ability. Now, we have to understand the difference between three basic terms, that is segregation, integration and inclusion, which is necessary to have a clear understanding about the term inclusive education. Now first, what is segregation? Segregated education occurs when students with disability learn completely separate from their peers in the form of special schools. Dear students, as you have seen in your daily life, that we have certain schools for the visually impaired, hearing impaired or other kinds of disability. So such schools believe in the principle of segregated education. Moreover, this school considered child as a problem in system. So they are taught with the entirely different curriculum and different methods of teaching. Next is integration. Integrated education places disabled students in a mainstream classroom with some adaptation and resources. In integrated education, we place the disabled students or students with diversity in the mainstream classroom by making certain changes in resources, but we expect them to fit in whatever type of resources or structure we provide them. Now, what is inclusive education? Inclusive education is a process of strengthening the capacity of education system to reach out to all learners. It includes restructuring the culture, policies and practices in school so that they can respond to the diversity of students in their locality. Contrast to segregated and integrated education, in inclusive education, our focus is to make change in the culture, policies and practices so that every learner with a different ability can be adjusted in the environment under one roof. Here you can see scope of inclusive education. If we have to define what is the scope of inclusive education, then it has a very wide scope. Under this, under the area of inclusive education, we can include the children with disability, having some physical, mental, emotional disability, or some kind of motor problem, like orthopedically handicapped or some visual problem. Even the learning disability are the part of children with disabilities. Next, we have girls living in different difficult circumstances. Sometimes we have a certain kind of population which lives in an entirely difficult circumstances, like living in very remote areas or in a area which is not easily accessible. So they also comes under the category of inclusive education. Moreover, here we are focusing on the minority population, that is girls. Next, we have children of migrant labor. Next, we have street children. Moreover, children in remote and tribal areas also come under the category of inclusive education, as well as working children. Other than the picture you are seeing, we have many other kinds of population which can be considered under the inclusive education, like we have people belonging to a linguistic minority group, or we have SCST population, or we have the population of children belonging to a specific culture or specific religion. They also can come under the category of scope of inclusive education. Now, several attempts have been made for inclusive education before independence and after independence. So, in this presentation, we will discuss attempts made after independence in our country. First, Article 45 was framed, which focused on universalization of elementary education. It also took into account the inclusive education. Next, we have Kothari Education Commission 1964-66, which also talked about the common school system and in which inclusive education was given due importance. Next, we have National Policy of Education 1968, then Integrated Education of Disabled Children Scheme IEDC 1974. Both these aspects talked about the inclusive education in detail. Then we have National Policy of Education 1986 and Program of Action 1992. Then we have the Rehabilitation Council of India Act RCI 1992, which deals with the legal procedure involved in the teaching of such children. Then we have People of Disability Act PDA 1995. Now, next we have District Primary Education Program DPEP 1994. All these programs talked about inclusive education and how to implement them. Next we have Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan SSA 2001. Next, we have Right to Education Act, RTE 2009. Next, a Comprehensive Plan of Action for Children and Youth with Disability 2005. So, in all these attempts, a focus is given for the inclusive education so that no children can be left behind. Now, what are the benefits of inclusion? If we are talking about inclusive education, so we must know certain benefits which will help us to include such children in the regular school system. The largest study of educational outcomes of 11,000 students with disability, known as the Longitudinal Transition Study, showed that when students with disability spend more time in general education classroom, they are more likely to score. A transition study was made, known as the Longitudinal Transition Study, which has the following conclusion. Number one, higher on standardized test of reading and mathematics. It means if we include children with diverse abilities in regular schools, in regular classroom, then they score high on the test of reading and mathematics. Moreover, they have fewer absences from school. It means they regularly come to school. Next, have fewer referrals for disruptive behavior. It means they don't engage any kind of disruptive behavior, or they don't show any kind of indiscipline problem. Next, they achieve more positive post-school outcomes. Moreover, they have more positive outcomes after leaving the school in their practical life. Moreover, inclusive education can be beneficial to all students in a class, not just students with special needs. As said by Gillies, inclusion helps students understand the importance of working together and foster a sense of tolerance and empathy. So here main focus is on that they learn working together or cooperate with each other. Moreover, it also fosters a sense of tolerance as well as empathy, or having an empathetic attitude for each other. A combination of inclusion and pull-out partial inclusion services has been shown to be beneficial to students with learning disability in the areas of reading comprehension, and preferential for the special education teachers delivering the services. As viewed by Marston, inclusive education helps in the area of reading comprehension as well as for the special education teachers delivering the services. It proved beneficial for the teachers who are engaged in the task of special education. A study conducted by Sale and Carey quoted that a study on inclusion compared integrated and segregated preschool children. The study found that children in integrated sites progress in social skills development, with the segregated children regressed. Here we can see that he talked about social skills development. Such children who are under the inclusive education environment, they are more progressive in their social skills development. Some more benefits are, some studies even show that implementing inclusion on a school-wide basis improves achievement of all students. Moreover, it reduces dropout rates and repetition of grades. Moreover, another benefit to be well mentioned in is other than the academic outcomes. So not only inclusive education helps in academic outcomes, it also helps in attitude and values that all students learn when they are educated together. So it also brings a change in their attitude and values. Inclusive schools promote acceptance. It helps in promoting acceptance, giving acceptance to each individual. Moreover, it helps in respect and support among children with and without disability. So each children with or without disability learn to respect and support the other. In developing country like India, inclusion proves to be an economical affair. If we are talking about the benefits of inclusion in our country, India, Here it proves to be an economical affair, because if we have to make a special arrangement, different arrangement for the children with the special needs, then we have to spend a lot for their education, for arranging the equipments. But if we took them under the inclusive education environment, then it will help in reducing the cost. From the humanitarian point of view also, the practice of inclusion is justified, as inclusion and participation are essential to human dignity and to the enjoyment and exercise of human rights as viewed by the Framework for Action, Salamanca Statements. So Salamanca Statement has viewed that inclusive education is also important from humanitarian point of view, because it promotes the sense of human dignity and helps in exercising the human rights.
A mediocre teacher explains, a good teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago, this is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.
ਜਰਨੈਲ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ, ਮੈਂ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਜੰਮਪਲ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਸਕੂਲਿੰਗ ਹੈ ਮੇਰੀ। ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਗਰਾਊਂਡਾਂ 'ਚ ਖੇਡਿਆ, ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੜ੍ਹਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਸੀ ਛੱਤਾਂ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਦੀ, ਅਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕ੍ਰੈਸ਼ਰ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ, ਸੀਮੈਂਟ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ, ਇੱਟਾਂ ਫੜਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ। ਯੂ ਕਾਂਟ ਥਿੰਕ ਆਫ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੱਕ ਆ ਗਏ। ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਰਹੇ ਇਸ ਕਾਲਜ ਦੇ, ਅਤੇ ਮੇਰੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਜੀ ਕਲਾਸ ਫੈਲੋ ਸੀਗੇ ਔਰ ਫਸਟ ਬੈਚ ਦੇ ਇਹ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟ ਸੀਗੇ। ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਫਰੀ ਆਫ ਕੋਸਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਕਈ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਰਹੇ, ਔਰ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖਾਣਾ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਰੀ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਸੀ, ਹੋਸਟਲ ਫੈਸਿਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੀਗੀਆਂ। ਇਸ ਦਾ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ, ਸਾਡੇ ਦੇਖਣ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ, ਔਰ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੰਨੀ ਸੋਚ ਸਾਡੀ ਮੈਨੇਜਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ। ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਮਈ ਜੂਨ ਦੇ ਮਹੀਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਧੁੱਪੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ, ਕਿੱਕਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਛਾਂ ਥੱਲੇ, ਅਤੇ ਉਹ ਨਾਲ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ। ਬੜੀ ਦੇਣ ਆ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ। ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਾਲਜ ਹੈਗਾ, ਇਹ ਰੂਰਲ ਨਾ ਸਮਝੋ ਇਹਨੂੰ, ਇਟਸ ਮੋਰ ਦੈਨ ਏ ਯੂਨੀਵਰਸਿਟੀ, ਯੂ ਨੋ।